we've been in the ministry for over 40 years, and we've faced down all kinds of attacks and mountains and all kinds of stuff, but I don't think we ever faced anything quite like this before. And we've always been prayer warriors. Larry, you and I have always been prayer warriors and just been so thrilled in our ministry to be able to teach people how to tap into the promises of God. And that's the greatest thrill in our lives, really, is to see it come to pass in people's lives. But when we started studying the Jewish roots, I think the thing that amazed us was that the more that we dug and pulled out the mysteries, the more the miracles were released.
Absolutely.
And so it's not just to have a heavy Rebbe. It's not just to have a, you know, some unique message. It's because we care about people.
And it works.
And it works. And we have stacks of testimonies of people that have received miracles. But I can say from my own standpoint in these last 2 years that, you know, you might, sometimes people think, well, you don't understand what I'm going through. You know, you don't even understand. Well, we all have our individual things that we're going through, but I guarantee you, we do understand what trauma is, and we do understand. And when you receive a devastating report, or your world falls out from underneath you, or someone you love has left you, all kinds of things happen in this life. And you may feel like there is absolutely no hope. And these last few months in the world, there's a lot of hopelessness. But we want to tell you today, you're not there alone. God sees, He cares, He has the answer for you. And when you get under your tallit and pray, I'm telling you, something supernatural happens. When I got under my tallit these last couple years for Lion, I mean, sometimes I'd go to war, I would be stomping and, you know, in my warfare mode. Sometimes I couldn't even speak.
Yeah.
And sometimes I was so broken and so devastated and so weak and frankly confused that all I could do was get under my tallit. And you know what I would read? Psalms 91. And I wouldn't just read it. I would speak it and pray it over our lives because it's God's promises. I wasn't pulling things out of the air. God, please help me. No, I was speaking His promises. And Psalms 91 tells us, He who dwells in the secret place, as Larry just taught us, of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And that's, I think, the first revelation. It's not just God with a little g. It's God with a capital G that you are connecting with. And when He gives us an opportunity, why would we pass that up? You know, and so you go through and whatever in Psalms 91, if you need a miracle for deliverance from your enemy, if you need fear to leave and courage to rise, no evil or no plague shall come upon you. That's a good one right now.
Yes, amen.
God will answer your prayers. He'd trample and tread on every enemy that you have. God will give you long life. Boy, did we pray that these last couple years. Long, long, healthy life. Divine covering and protection, miracle victories. Angels will guard you. Angels will guard you. God will set you on high. He will raise you up above the circumstances, the issues, the problems, the statistics, the reports, and He will bring you to a place on high. He will honor you and favor you, and you will see the salvation of the Lord in eternity and in this life. Boy, if that doesn't stir your own heart up.
Yeah, and a lot of people, you know, when you said that last one, salvation, a lot of people think salvation is forgiveness of sin, and that's part of it. That's the main thing. But salvation is from every one of these enemies
Absolutely.
That is talked about. And He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High God. If God has a secret place, wouldn't we want to know where that secret place is?
Yes.
Jesus Himself.
Amen.
They say, well, that's the Old Testament. Jesus Himself said, when He sees you in the secret place,
Amen.
He will reward you openly. Ancient Jewish wisdom tells us what the secret place is.
Yes.
Jesus, and we're going to get into this in just a moment. Jesus did not wear a long white Roman robe.
Right.
Jesus wore, according to the Torah, According to the Bible, Jesus wore a tallit, just like this, or almost just like this, because he understood the weapons of our warfare. They're not carnal. They're not of this world, but they are mighty in God. One of the main things is when you cover your head, the enemy is forbidden to come in and speak to you. Because a double-minded man is unstable in all of his ways. But when we go into the secret place, it's your personal holy of holies. That's where the anointing of God, the supernatural power of God, is released into your life. Amen.